Hi and welcome back, it's Vicky here and today I'm featuring the latest release by Altenew. Just like always, they have come up with amazing products. This release includes stamps, dies, embossing folders and even new ink pads. Today I'm going to share 3 cards and I will be using as many of the new products as I can, so you can see the new products in action and choose your favorites. Also make sure to visit my blog, you will find there all the info that you need to join the giveaways. For my first card, I'm going to start with my absolute favorite from the whole release. This is the Goldfish Pond Die Set. It gives you 3 different fish designs along with lots of props so you can build a lovely scene. It is a layering stamp but super easy to build, you only get the outline and a color. You can use the designs to create an eye bird view from the top or use other designs like this one for example to create a scene from the side where, for example, inside the lake. Now I'm going for an eye bird view today and I will start by stamping my fish. Now for the fish there is a second layer to add the color. For that I will work with inks from the Warm and Cozy Oval set and notice how I have all those colors on the outside. These come from this set of stickers. These are actually supposed to go all around the mini ink cubes, but I cut them in half and I stick them one on the front and the other at the back. These are my go-to inks for stamping and I absolutely love the way that they are now nicely organized. So for my fish, I'm going to work with Orange Cream and Fire Brick. These are the second and the last in the set. If you don't want to use the layers, you can always use your markers to color in the outlines. So you can turn these fish into being any type of fish that you like. I decided to use the layers and I think that now they look like koi fish. I did stamp one of the flowers with black and I'm going to stamp one of the big leaves with lime and this is going to float on top of my pond. Now this looks a little bit flat, so to add some dimension I'm going to use the darker shade of green from the same set, which is Fresh Leaf. I'm going to ink up only the outside edges and stamp on top. This is going to give just a little bit of shadow and it's going to blend even more as the time passes and the ink dries. I did use the matching dies to cut out everything, but there is no matching die for the big leaf, so I'm going to fuzzy cut it. Now, if you notice, there are black lines on all the designs that I'm going to use, but not around the leaf. And that's why I'm going to bring in my Altenew fine liners. There is a set available with lots of different nibs. I'm going to try and find which nib matches the art line on the rest of the stamped images. I can get a little crazy with details like that. So since all my cutouts do have black lines, I want to have black lines on the leaf as well. And that's why I'm just going to draw it all around. And once I have the black line there, I can put my mind at ease and then I will bring in my scissors and start fuzzy cutting that leaf. Now for creating the base of the pond, you can use just a piece of blue cardstock. You can even ink up a card with your favorite ink colors. However, I decided to add some sparkle and I'm going to create my very own glitter cardstock. For that I'm covering up completely this panel with double-sided tape. I'm going to peel it off and then I'm going to apply on top very fine glitter. This is by Nouveau. It is going to stick all over the place and once you cover it up completely, then use a bone folder to burnish it. This is going to make sure that all the glitter is nicely stuck on the adhesive. And fine glitter really sticks nicely there, it's not going to create a mess. If you want, you can even use a Swiffer cloth over it to make sure that you clean up any loose glitter. I did cut out a little frame which I'm sticking on top of my pond and I did use foam tape underneath so it is quite dimensional. I'm going to stick the whole thing on top of my card base. And then finally I will create my little scene. I do have foam squares at the back of the fish and I'm going to stick them as if they are creating a little circle. I'm also going to stack down the flower and the leaf. I will chop that leaf just so that I can tuck it in the corner. and I will finish it off with a sentiment from the same stamp set. Super pretty and really sparkly, and here are some close-up photos. And let's move on to the second card. For this one, I will use the You Are Beautiful stamp set. It gives you this lovely outline flower that you can color with your favorite coloring mediums or use the layers included. There is also a matching stencil that you can use if you want to color it with that. I'm starting by stamping the flower as well as a couple of leaves. And this is one of the new oval sets. You get these four colors. It is called Martian Terrain, and I'm going to use those so you can see those colors in action. Since there are only three layers for the flower, I'm not going to use the lighter one. So this is Canyon Clay, and this is where I realized that at the back now they do have a number. So you know 1, 2, 3, 4, you know which one is lighter all the way to the darker one. Now this is quite of a solid stamp, and I forgot to prep it. Rub it with the back of my palm, like I always do, so it is going to come up a little bit splotchy. It is the first time that I'm stamping with that, so I will do that one more time just to make sure that everything is going to look nice and smooth. For the second layer, I used burnt red, and then for the darker layer, the third one, I used mahogany bark. For adding some interest on my background, I'm going to use this new 3D embossing folder. This is called Angled Mosaic, and it gives you this lovely design, really versatile for pretty much any card. For that, I'm going to use my go-to technique. I will work on white cardstock, so I want to have kind of an off-white look at the back. And that's why I'm inking up the top of the folder with vanilla. I am running it through my die cutting machine, and this is the C6 one, so I use these three platforms, and then I am going to show you the lovely detail, and you will see that that vanilla color is only on the nooks and crannies of the design, so it makes it look even more dimensional. Now I did stick that with foam tape on top of yellow cardstock. I'm going to pop on top the flower, and I do have foam squares at the back, and then I'm going to tuck underneath the leaves. And this is one of those card designs that you can use for pretty much any occasion, depending on the sentiment that you decide to stamp on top. I decided to go with thanks, and this is the bold thanks die set that has the actual word as well as the outline. And here are some close-up photos on the card. Notice that I did add a few of those clear bubbles because they look as if they are droplets and make the flower look even more fresh. And finally, let's move on to the third card for today. This time I'm going to use the Ornamental Feature 3D Embossing Folder. This is absolutely stunning. It gives you this middle section where you can just emboss it and stamp your sentiment there, and you have a pretty card ready to go. I think this would be great if you want to create an anniversary or a wedding card, and you can emboss with gold at the center the sentiment. Just lovely and super simple. However, I'm going to take it a step further, and I'm trying to create some shadows here so you can probably see the lovely design that you get. And it is quite difficult to catch that beautiful design with all the lighting that I have on my filming area. I'm going to embellish my panel by using some of the leaves and the flowers from the new stamp set, which is called Blissful Blossoms. This is absolutely stunning. It gives you bigger and smaller flowers, as well as lovely whimsical leaves that I really love. So you can see I'm stamping a bunch of them here, and I used parrot and bamboo inks to stamp the layers. These are only two layers, one on top of the other, to create the shadows, and they don't have a black outline, another favorite. I just placed on top of the middle section that glitter silver cardstock that I have, and now I am planning to stick that on top where my sentiment is going to be, but for now I'm going to embellish the top at the bottom of that silver cardstock. Now, if you notice, I did stamp these leaves, but didn't stamp the flowers on top, just because I want to customize them and I want to mainly use them as leaves. So I'm going to go pretty much symmetrical, up and down, and since I do have a symmetrical design at the back, I think this would be best. However, I'm going to play a little bit with the flowers. I do have only 5 flowers, which I'm going to play with. Just having an odd number is better. All the flowers that I stamped and die cut are identical, and I did use the new oval set with the blue shades, which is called Northern Shore, so you can see some of the colors in action. To add some sparkle, I'm going to add some gems at the center of all those flowers, and I didn't want to go with yellow ones, but I found this color that matches perfectly with blues. I love how elegant this card looks, and I think it would make a lovely card for pretty much any occasion again, depending on the sentiment that you decide to stamp. I did white emboss "Thanks for Everything" on that navy blue strip of paper, and I'm going to stick it directly on top of that silver cardstock, and I did cut out the sentiment slightly smaller so you will be able to see that silver cardstock on top and at the bottom. So this is going to finish off the card, and here are some close-up photos. And these were all the 3 cards that I made for today, showcasing products from the latest release by Altenew. Just like always, you will find everything that I used linked down below in the description area. Also, don't forget that this is part of a blog hub. If you want to enter the giveaways, make sure to visit my blog and find all about it. I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment and have a lovely day! Thank you.